Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and I'm talking about lip filler and cannula versus needle today. Common question because Restylane Silk, it's the only product that's FDA approved to actually use the cannula, but because of that, there's a lot of awareness and a lot of trainings, and people use the cannulas, of course, for many fillers, but in this country now, it's approved and known. So what do we use, a needle or cannula? What, where, when, why? It's a great question. Now, let's go through the needle, of course, is sharp, and it's typically people are using a 30 gauge, but if we tend to use more structural, strong products, even in the lip, so 27 gauge is real common. Obviously, it's sharp, and it enters the skin, the mucous membrane of the lip. If we take the cannula side of things, the most common, people would say 27, but really a 25 gauge isn't as common as the 27, but it will be, because a 25 gauge is, in my opinion, more correct to use than a 27. So a 25 gauge cannula is blunt. What do? We make 2 to 4 openings on the skin. So the white, not the vermilion pink of the lip. We make those openings, and then it's a longer instrument, typically 1.5 inches, so it looks a bit daunting. And we go in through the white of the skin into the mucous membrane, and it's blunt, and it doesn't create the cutting that a needle would do. So that's the difference between a needle and the cannula. Now, advantages and disadvantages. With the needle, of course it's sharp, and we're going into the vermilion or the red part of the lip several times. So there's a little more trauma there, a little more risk of swelling, bruising, and maybe a little bit more pain. So we'll talk about pain, and we'll talk about kind of an oddity feeling, because pain is that sharp sensation that's variable. Some people say they have pain, and some say it doesn't hurt at all. And then you take the cannula, it's blunt, but it does have that weird feeling that it's kind of going through the tissues, and people kind of see it in their periphery. So some people do get basovagal or a bit lightheaded with the cannula, even though it's not as quote unquote painful, it's a bit odd feeling. So those are two different kind of sensations and mentation issues, cannula versus needle. So trauma. Now, because of that, the needle would cause a little more bruising. You're just making more openings in a mucous membrane, and it's sharp, and certainly there's more bruising. So if someone has an event coming up, I'll often reach for the cannula because most times they won't get any bruising at all, and I find less swelling, less openings. Another difference between them is simply personal preference. If people have had both, they might do a cannula once and a needle another time, then we'll ask them, what did you like better? And they have a preference based on all those factors that I talked about. Now, with the needle, sometimes, most times, you're going to see that the practitioner will grab a needle at some point in the injection process. Why? Why is it that if you're getting cannula injections, there's a couple needle pokes too? The reason is, as you imagine, a 25 gauge blunt cannula is bigger and thicker. The vermilion border, which is where the white of the skin meets the red vermilion of the lip, is very precise, and there's actual a potential space in there. It's easier to get to with a nice fine 30 gauge needle and create that crisp projection that says, I'm youthful. And that's what people want. So the vermilion border is a little better served with a needle versus a 25 gauge cannula. A 27 gauge cannula is pretty good on that vermilion border, but you're gonna grab it anyway, likely to do a little at the philtrum, which are those pillars that go from the nose to the top of the lip. Also at the edge of the mouth, because we're talking lip, it's lip volume, but it's also raising the edge of the lip to look pretty, and that might mean some droplet form injections to support that modiolus at the edge of the lip. So there's cannula, there's needle, there's bruising, pain, downtime, personal preference, and sometimes it's a combination of using both, and some practitioners are just more comfortable with one or the other. So tell us your preference. Have you had them both done? And if you're a practitioner, what do you like to use and how do you do it? Join us and subscribe to my channel here to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.